So it's about 5:30 a.m. I'm biking through the streets near where I live to try to catch the International Space Station because I want to try to photograph it. According to my ISS spotter app, the space station will become visible somewhere around here, theoretically. It will peak at its height somewhere around here, and then it will go back towards the horizon there. So basically like that. So I'm gonna point this camera, towards this part of the sky. And the idea is I'm gonna take like maybe a 4 minute exposure just of this part of the sky and see if I can get like a streak. Depends on the clouds, of course. There's a cloud here, but I think where the ISS is gonna be is gonna be right here. I'm gonna blow out the lighting just so I can focus on a star. I assume that if I focus on the star, then I can focus on the ISS. The International Space Station encircles the Earth every 90 minutes or so. Sometimes, a little after sunset, or like today, before sunrise, you can see it fly through the sky. Its visibility in a given location comes and goes, and you may see it several nights in a row, and then not for a few weeks. Tonight is supposed to be pretty good, and this free app tells you where the ISS is now, so you can watch it approaching your area, which is the blue dot. For me, Osaka. So it's supposed to be visible in about a minute and a half from now. Okay, I see it. There it is. It's higher in the sky than I thought for some reason, so I've changed my camera pointing over. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and start the exposure. And trust me, it looks cool. It's just bright moving, bright fast moving star is what it looks like. Only one chance to get this right. And man, I don't know if I got the settings right. Because the space station was in a different kind of, it was much higher than I thought, I don't know why. It's still visible to the naked eye, but it's very, very faint. And I think with all this light pollution, I probably am not, I don't know. I'm gonna keep exposing. About 5 minutes maybe four. I had the camera on bulb and stopped it manually after not quite a 4 minute exposure. After being momentarily distracted by a gorgeous crescent moonrise, I packed up and biked home, hopeful that the bright space station showed up in my photo. After some sleep and breakfast, I opened the RAW file in GIMP and played with the settings. And this is what I got. The ISS is in this frame, but it's pretty faint. You have to zoom in to really notice it. The main thing you notice is the very bright streetlights and their unfortunate green lens flare blobs. A few stars are visible spinning around Polaris, which is just out of frame to the upper left. All brighter than the ISS, which, with the naked eye, had been quite bright before it got to this part of the sky. Since I wanted some foreground interest in the shot, not just empty sky with the ISS streaking through it, I abandoned the original angle when the ISS was much higher than I expected, and quickly chose where the ISS was heading for the horizon. By that time it had grown quite faint, though. It always pays to plan well. By the way, you can calculate the settings for a several minutes long exposure without having to do a bunch of several minutes long test shots. Instead, do 30 second test shots and some simple math. Here's how. First, set the aperture to whatever you want for the depth of field. I used a very small aperture, a high number of f20, because of the light pollution and the long exposure. Then you take 30 second test shots, changing the ISO until it looks right. This was ISO 100, way too dark. This was ISO 1000, looks good. But ISO 1000 can be grainy and you don't really want to use it. So, divide the ISO that looks best by 100, which is 10 in this case. Then set your ISO back to 100 and you can now take an exposure for 30 seconds times your number, which here was 10. So 30 seconds times 10 is 5 minutes at ISO 100 and F20.
those were my settings, and it was easier to calculate this way than taking a whole bunch of 5-minute test exposures. Of course, I realized that the ISS was gone and stopped the exposure before 5 minutes, so it was all a bit sloppy. But I got the ISS. I won't hang this photo on my wall, but it was a fun adventure and I learned a lot for next time. Unfortunately, the ISS spotter app said that this was my last chance for at least a week, maybe several weeks. But next time the International Space Station passes over Osaka, its panels reflecting the bright sunlight onto me, I'll be ready and even better prepared. Thanks for coming along with me. See you on the next adventure.